Hey everybody, Greg Davies here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Spry menu bar in Dreamweaver. First, I'm going to show you how to place it in your page, and then I'm going to show you how to edit it to make it look exactly the way you want it to look. Let's get started. I've got a blank HTML page here. I've already saved it as sprymenu.html. Just simply select where you want to place your Spry menu bar, and let's go to the Insert panel, Spry tab, and down here, select Spry menu bar. We've got the option of a horizontal layout or a vertical layout. I select horizontal layout, hit OK. And here's my Spry menu bar. I'll turn live view on. And you can see it's very functional. It has four buttons. Two of them have a drop-down menu that is indicated by this little arrow image that's placed there. And this item 3.1 even has a third level sub-menu. I turn live view off. And let's edit our Spry menu. When you roll over your Spry menu, as I'm doing here, you can see this little blue tab shows up. If you want to edit your Spry object, just select that blue tab. And notice the properties panel becomes populated with all of the properties for that specific Spry object. And you can edit it. Another way of selecting your Spry object would be simply selecting inside of it, and you could select it using the tag selector. So let's edit our Spry menu. We have three levels of navigation here. The first is the actual menu. So these four are these four right here. Let's say I want five buttons. I just hit this plus button, and I now have five buttons. I've got this new untitled item here. I select it and I rename it to item 5. Hit enter and I move it down the list all the way down to the bottom. You can name your items whatever you want. Just select the item and you can name it right here, and you can link it to something right here. And again, we have three levels of navigation, so if you select this item 1, you will see that it has a second level submenu. Let's say I need a third level submenu for this item 1.2. Select it, and over here, I just hit the plus button to add a third level submenu for it. Honestly, I would never use third level submenus, but you have that option. I just delete it using the minus button. And let's take a look at the CSS. When we created the Spry menu, Dreamweaver created some CSS styles and JavaScript for us. You can see them right here. They are attached to the file, and they would normally be in a Spry assets folder in our local site, but they actually don't really come into existence until you save this page. So let's save this page real quick. And Dreamweaver is basically saying that these supporting files have been copied to our local site to make this Spry menu work. I hit OK. And now, if you take a look at your files, just hit the refresh button, or F5, and you will see we've got this new Spry assets folder here, containing all of the supporting files for our menu bar. And we can now style our menu bar with CSS. So let's go to the CSS panel and open up Spry menu bar horizontal CSS. This is the CSS file that Dreamweaver created for our Spry menu, and this is what we're going to work with to style our Spry menu. Now, if you select inside of your menu bar, you will see we've got links inside of list items inside of an unordered list. That's the way to set up a menu bar. We use unordered lists, list items, and links, and those are the elements that are styled in the CSS file. So first of all, let's take a look at how to change the width of our buttons. To change the width of your first level buttons, select UL menu bar horizontal LI, go to box, and you can see that the width is 8 em, and 8 times 16 equals 128 pixels. So our list items are basically 128 pixels wide. And this is where you can change the width of your first level buttons. Just hit cancel out of here. and to change the width of your second and third level submenu buttons. First, you need to change the width of this rule, UL menu bar horizontal UL, and then you need to change the width of this rule, UL menu bar horizontal UL LI, and they should be the exact same wide. Now let's talk about changing the height of your buttons. To change the height of your buttons, select UL menu bar horizontal A, the link, and you can change the font size, which is not specified here, so our links inherit the default font size, which is 16 pixels. You can change it if you want. It's going to change the height of your buttons. Let's go to box. And the second thing you can do to change the height of your buttons is changing the padding of your links. We already have some padding here. The top padding is 0.5 em times 16 equals 8 pixels. So the top padding is 8 pixels. You can change the top padding and the bottom padding to change the height of your buttons. Hit cancel. And let's see how to edit the font. First of all, we have normal font and rollover font. To edit the normal font, just select UL menu bar horizontal A, go to type, and you can edit the normal font right here. You can change the normal font color right here. I hit cancel. And to edit the rollover font, just select this long rule. I'm not gonna read it, you can see it on my screen. And you can edit the rollover font right here, and the rollover font color right here. I hit cancel. And let's talk about changing the background color. Just like with the font, we have normal background color and rollover background color. To change the normal background color, select UL menu bar horizontal A, go to background, and you can change the normal background color right here. I hit cancel. And to change the rollover background color, select this long rule again, go to background, and you can change the rollover background color right here. I hit cancel. And let's take a look at using background images. But first, we need some background images, so let's go over to Fireworks and let's create a new Fireworks document. 1000 pixel wide and 1000 pixel tall canvas will be enough. The canvas color will be transparent. I hit OK. And here's our Fireworks document. Let's grab the rectangle tool and let's create a rectangle. It's gonna be 100 pixels wide and 35 pixels tall, because by default our Spry menu buttons are 35 pixels tall and I haven't changed it. The color will be blue. Let's apply some filters to it, like Photoshop Live Effects. I select Gradient Overlay. And the opacity will be 25. And it looks good. And just hit OK. And get my pointer tool. Select my rectangle. And hold down the Alt key or Option key on the Mac and just drag a copy over here. And this one will be green for rollover buttons. Get my pointer tool, select my rectangles, and I right click on my rectangles or hold down your Control key and click on them on the Mac, and select Insert Rectangular Slice. We need multiple slices, one for both of them, and here they are. I just change their width to 1 pixel because these background images are going to be horizontally repeated. I click my canvas to deselect my slices, and over here I select the first slice, which is this one, and I rename it to BG underscore spry menu. Select the other one and I rename it to bg underscore spry menu underscore rollover. Good. I select the first slice. I export it to PNG32 format. I just right click on the slice or control click on the Mac and select export selected slice. I'm going to save it in our local site folder and the file name will be the slice name. I click save. I select the other slice. I export it to PNG32 format. I just right click on the slice, export selected slice, click save, and I just save my fireworks document. I'm going to save it in our local site folder and the file name will be spry menu PNG format. Click save and let's go back to Dreamweaver. Select UL menu bar horizontal A. Go to background and I just browse the normal background image. Hit OK. Once again, turn Live View on. And notice all of the buttons that have another submenu attached to them show the background color instead of the background image. And that's because they have separate styles having this little arrow as background image. And so they don't inherit the background image change we just did. Let's fix it. Select menu bar horizontal. Select menu bar horizontal in menu bar item submenu. Go to background. And let's browse the normal background image instead of the arrow. Hit OK. Delete this no repeat value because we want our background image to repeat and it's going to repeat by default, so we can just delete it and delete the background positions as well, both of them. Hit OK. And our first level buttons now show our background image, but if you roll over item 3 you will see that item 3.1 has a third level submenu attached to it and it still doesn't show our background image. So let's select UL menu bar horizontal UL in menu bar item submenu. Go to background and we're gonna do the same thing. Browse the normal background image instead of the arrow. Hit OK. Delete the no repeat value and delete the background positions. Hit OK. And all of our buttons now show our background image. Awesome. We just need the rollover background image. So let's select this rule. Go to background and browse the rollover background image. Hit OK. Once again. And our rollover image is functioning except from the buttons that have another submenu attached to them. So let's select this rule, go to background and browse the rollover background image. Hit OK. Delete the no repeat value and delete the background positions. Hit OK and then select this rule, go to background delete the no repeat value and delete the background positions. Hit OK and our background is now fully functional. Awesome. And finally, let's talk about the borders. If you take a look at your submenu, you will see that the submenu containers have a gray border on all sides. You can see it right here. If you want to edit that, just select UL menu bar horizontal UL, go to border, and you can edit that border right here. I hit cancel. And if you want your buttons to have some borders, select UL menu bar horizontal A, the link, go to border, and right here you can apply a border to all of your buttons in this menu bar. I hit cancel, and this is how you create a Spry menu bar in Dreamweaver, and this is how you can quickly and easily edit it. You might want to create a div tag to hold your menu bar. I'm not going to do that now. Anyway, I hope you learned something. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want more videos from me, go to my website, easywebdesignsystem.com, and join my list. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye.